everyone. Today I have a very long overdue video that's mostly about the Pentel Orenz. So what is prompting this video is the Orenz Manish, which is a very limited edition pencil that I had ordered before I left for Japan. And then when I was in Japan, I got to see it in the stores. It was excruciating because I was so excited about this pencil, but I knew that ours were on the way, and so I didn't want to buy myself one in the store because that would be silly. So the Pentel Orenz is available in a 0.2 and a 0.3. This is of the very stupidly named Manish line. I hate what they named it. I'm sorry about that, but it's not under my control. I have like several theories as to why they named it that, but I'm not even gonna go down that path because then I will spark some kind of annoying debate. So the yellow one, which is yellow and gray, has the bowler hat on it. All of the designs are available in 0.2 and 0.3. So no matter which design you like, you can get either size. As long as you act quickly enough. I doubt we would be able to restock these. This one is like a mint green, and I guess I would call that cream. And it has a bicycle design on it. This one, they're all so cute. I have a very hard time deciding which one I like the most. This one is a sky blue and pale yellow, and has eyeglasses on it. And this one has a lovely brown, you know how much I love brown, and a pink and a coffee or tea cup on it. I imagine that it's coffee because I'm more of a coffee drinker, but I feel like it can also be tea. So yeah, the Pentel Orenz, I've done other videos on the Orenz, but it has, let me, hold on one moment. I'm gonna go get one that's already open. Okay, here is an Orenz I have in my own personal collection. I collect Orenz, so that should tell you how much I like them. But anyway, a lot of people end up damaging their Orenz because they don't know how to use it. So I do think it's worth going over this. So having a pencil as fine, especially as 0.2, we have a very fragile nose. So when you're travel, like when you throw your Orenz in your backpack, or basically anytime you're not using your Orenz, you need to store that nose inside the tip of the pencil. So in order to do that, you press on the top of your pencil and push your tip in. So you push while you release the top, and that stores your nose for you. Now, when you actually go to write, you'll want your nose to be out. This is gonna protect your lead from breaking easily. And the other important thing is you will not extract the lead. You really want it to be pretty much flush with the end. Maybe you want the teeniest bit of overlap. So I really, when I'm starting out, I make sure that I don't have a bunch of lead sticking out. And it is going to expel, do you say extract or expel? Your lead for you as you write. And in this way, your lead is protected. And you don't end up with a lot of breakage like you would expect from such a fine pencil. I've had other videos about why I like super fine pencils. A lot of it has to do with studying Japanese and using it for furigana, but there are also a lot of other purposes I've used it for. If, you know, if I'm studying math or a code, then it's very nice to have a fine pencil to write notes above equations and to kind of like annotate what you're studying, because a lot of times you have a very small space So you really want a fine tip pencil. There is a hidden eraser under the cap of the Arends. It's replaceable, of course. What else do I want to talk about with that? I mostly just wanted to like teach you how to protect the tip, because if you're going to be using this pencil, there is a special way to use it. If you're not using it that special way, you're not going to appreciate the pencil, because your lead's going to be breaking all the time because it's so fine. It's hard not to break a 0.2 pencil unless you're using it right. And the other problem you might have is that you're going to bend that nose and then your pencil's going to be jammed and you're going to think that your pencil's, you know, sucky, but really what happened was you broke it. So I want to be, you know, kind of clear when I talk about the Arends about how to use it. It is, you know, it was a new thing for me in terms of the way of using it. So let me set my Snoopy Arends aside. And I know some people are going to ask, no, we do not sell this. I don't know if they still make it. Okay. So we've got the Arends Manish. Ultimately, I ended up choosing the 0.2 pink because I really like this pink-brown combo. But it was really hard for me to make a decision because I love them all so much. And I think all the colors look awesome. So that is what's going on for the Arends as far as like limited edition stuff available on our store now. We also have, you know, aside from the traditional Arends, there's now available a Arends rubber grip. So if you need a thicker, more comfortable grip, you would like the Arends rubber grip. Here are some available colors. It is also available in 0.2 and 0.3. You know, you use it the same way that I showed you on the Snoopy one. All of the Arends, you would use that way. And they do kind of remind you on the back of your, when you get your package, like, you know, don't extract the lead. You really want it flush with the pipe. So that's that for the rubber grip. They also have an Arends metal grip now, which I brought some to show you. Let's see. These are all Arends metal grip. Arends metal grip, again, also available in 0.2 and 0.3. So for someone who wants a sturdier metal grip pencil, what I should do is weigh them. We're going to weigh them and annotate the video because some people really like to know if there's a weight difference with the pencils. Might be hard for you to pick between these two styles of Arends. Okay, that is about it for the Arends. I just wanted to go over those because we've gotten so many new ones lately, especially at limited edition, that people who are interested in the Arends, now is a good time to pick one that you like, especially if you like the limited edition. So something that pairs really well with the Arends, which is also new to our store, is the Ein Sala eraser. The cool thing about this eraser is how thin it is. So let me show you something. Like, this is a very common, popular one in Japan, the Uni plastic eraser. So you can see the thickness compared to this. So while it's true that you're getting a lot less eraser with this, it's more for people who are interested in the precision, which is probably going to be the case if you're using something like an Arends. So that's the Ein Sala. Since I've talked about the new Arendses, I wanted to make sure you guys know that the Delgard is available in this LX version now. People have been liking this lately. The Delgard also has a pipe that kind of it bounces and comes out while you're writing to protect your lead, so you're less likely to get breakage. Now, the new Delgard LX is only available in 0.5 right now, but the regular Delgard is available in 0.3, 0.5, and 0.7 in a lot of different colors. The Delgard LX has a metal grip. It's a, what do you call, like a brushed matte metal? It's really pretty. Feels nice. It feels like a really nice quality pencil. I feel like this would make a really nice gift for someone, you know, who likes mechanical pencils. Now, I believe the black one is also metal, but it's just a brushed matte black.
Yep.
It's really nice. Refillable eraser, of course. So yeah, it's a little more high-end feeling compared to the original Delgard. That is all I wanted to mention in the mechanical pencil realm. I hope that this video helped you if you're thinking about picking out an Arenz or a Delgard or just a mechanical pencil in general. Have a great day. Bye.